You know, there's a lot of items that you ran down before we started to record here that we could talk about concerning Nebraska football, and many of them are more important than what I'm going to lead with, but because of the interest in this all the time, anytime you bring up some kind of betting angle, then people's ears perk up, and lines were released across the country concerning week one and really games across the country, and we addressed those last week. The Nebraska-Oklahoma game and some of the key games in the Big Ten that have been released. But just here in the last couple of days, the over-under win-loss total has been released, and Nebraska sits at 5.5. How does that hit you?
Right on the nail, if you ask me. You want them to win six games. That's what you're looking at. And we've talked about this until we're blue in the face. You know, six games and a bowl game, a bowl trip, makes all the difference in the world right now, and especially with the schedule that they have. Now, can they win more than 5.5, or more than six games? Yeah, they sure can. Can they lose more than six? Absolutely. So, you know, it's hard to say, but that's where, until they can prove something different than what they've done, you know, winning four games a couple years in a row like that, I think 5.5 is just exactly what Vegas wants. So I'm not going to argue with those guys. They know a lot more about it than I do, and that's why I don't gamble. So that's exactly where it should be.
Yeah, if you look at the schedule, of course, with a lot of the lines that came out, the over-unders, they put a win total right on a whole number, so there's a possibility that if you lay a wager, it could come right smack dab on that number. It's a push, you get your money back, but with Nebraska at 5.5, of course,
all about the unknown.
You're going to basically either win or lose money there. When I look at this schedule, they're drawing a difficult assignment out of the MAC, so even though they should beat Buffalo, that's not a given. The Fordham game's a given. You know, I'm looking, I start that kind of analysis in looking at over-unders with, okay, where are the wins? Where are the certain wins? And I'm only coming up with one that I just, without a doubt, could put on the line. The Buffalo game's a near certainty, so they're a two. Now, obviously, they're going to win more than two games, but in terms of knowing, hey, they're going to beat this team, everybody else, those are winnable and losable games, all of them.
Yeah, they are, but obviously getting out of the gate with the Illinois team that has a brand-new coaching staff and Brent Bielema, who I'm really shocked. I've heard a lot of really bad things about him from Arkansas fans here lately, and I didn't know things were that bad. But that's going to be a whole new makeup with Illinois. So Nebraska, you got to figure, is going to be favored in that game. If not, it's going to be really close. And then Buffalo, which you thought might have been a tougher game until with all the coaching turnover that they had on that staff and a lot of personnel moves as well.
Good point.
Yeah, and so that's you don't know what kind of Buffalo team you're getting. And then you throw Fordham in there. And so Nebraska should be favored in all three of those opening games in my mind. Obviously, Oklahoma is going to be favored next, but besides Ohio State and any of those other road games, Nebraska is going to be, if not favored in most of those other games, then it's going to be really close. So right now, I think we've talked about before, is that there's nothing going on at this time of year, so we throw out all these odds and try to figure out what's going to happen here when nobody actually has any kind of clue how it's going to all end up.
So they open at Illinois. Of course, they lost to the Illini last year, but I believe them to be a better team than Illinois. The game is on the road. I would say that that's a game that they win 65 to 75% of the time, something in that range.
Yeah.
Okay. They beat Fordham. They should beat Buffalo. Again, it's not completely lock, stock, barrel, but about 90-some percent certainty that they beat Buffalo. and they're 3-0. And then what I typically do is I don't try to go through and with a lot of teams that are on the same level, meaning Minnesota, Northwestern, Purdue, Nebraska, just pick out every game and say, well, they're going to win that game, they're going to lose that game. I bunch them together and say, okay, here's five like games, Purdue, Minnesota, Northwestern, those kind of games, and say, it would be good if Nebraska could win, let's say, three of the five. That would be good. Yep. Two out of five isn't so great. One out of five would be a disaster, that sort of thing, and look at it in terms of probabilities. What's probably going to happen? Well, they're probably going to be 3-0 when they go to Oklahoma, and they're probably going to lose that game. They could fight and win it. It wouldn't shock me, but right now they're about a 3-touchdown underdog. They might be the better team when they go to Michigan State. I think that Nebraska fans should believe that they're a better team than Michigan State. It is a road game, but I would give them maybe a 55-45 or 60-40 lean in that one. So if they start off this season at 4-1 with a Northwestern team at home, then, man, they're off to a really solid season, even though, like we've talked about, the back end is brutal. But if they could start 4-1, 5-2 in that range, 5-2 seems very attainable. And then after that, it gets rough down the stretch. And to be able to steal one against Ohio State, Wisconsin, Iowa would be a step in the right direction, something we haven't seen under Scott Frost yet. We're talking about three of the top 15 teams in the country, if they play up to what the expectations are.
Right, and that's monumental, and that's what you're looking for right now to move this program back in the direction that everybody wants it to be, to where they expect it to be at. Obviously, I agree with you 100%, and I think it's a big key that this isn't something that we've seen lately, that if Nebraska can start off the season 3-0, that gives you a lot of momentum. It gives you a lot of confidence that you've been lacking for the last several years, basically. And then to go in and to go play one of the top teams in the country in their house that early in the season, that's right there going to show you where your team is at right now. And if you can put on a respectable showing there in Norman and you come out of there, you're 3-1, and then you take on a team that historically is always a close game, but in most people's minds, Nebraska usually should win that game. And that's one of those 50-50 games that you just laid out, that Nebraska has not been able to come through and win in the last few years. And with the kind of, if they're 3-0 and they put on a good showing at Oklahoma and don't get embarrassed and make it a game, I think this team comes out after that with so much confidence, knowing that they can go play with the big boys. And I think it makes it a lot more interesting on that back half of that brutal schedule, to all of a sudden you don't see a team that's just going to lay down and fight for everything they got. And we're going to end up with hopefully with different results than we've been used to here the last few years.
Greg, we're going to dream just a little bit with Dewey here. 9-3.
Love it. Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's go that route for just a second. So if that happens, most likely what that's going to look like is losing to Oklahoma and Ohio State and splitting with Wisconsin and Iowa, losing one of those, but winning one of those, and then beating everybody that, I'm not going to say Nebraska is supposed to beat, but that's on that same level, Minnesota, Illinois, Michigan, until they show us last year was an aberration. Maybe Michigan's on that level. We don't know. They've been above that level, but they were awful last year. Mm-hmm. That, can you know how rabid this fan base is. You know how loyal they are. If Nebraska gives them, let's say, even an 8-4 season where they play all the big boys tough, lose, but take care of business elsewhere, 8-4, let's say, how excited would that fan base be going into 22?
Well, exactly. You want to be those Aer Lingus guys with the Aer Lingus Classic that are trying to sell tickets to Ireland right now. If that happens, those tickets, I'm not sure when they go up for sale, but they're going to go pretty quick anyway, because Garth Brooks' concert coming here to Memorial Stadium sold out in 47 minutes. So if that tells you a little bit of something about how starved people are around here for anything, an 8-4 season, my goodness, people would be dancing in the streets all winter long, waiting for spring football to start and, see their brand new toy that is finally back and just got rebuilt and it's all shiny again. You know, that's what they want around here. So, I mean, that would be huge. That would be huge. And you know what? I mean, Dewey, 9-3 right there, you named three losses right there. If you lose to Oklahoma and Ohio State and, say, Wisconsin, and you have 9 wins, you got to probably say that team's ranked in, maybe the top 15 teams in the country.
Against that schedule, they better be.
Yeah. So who knows? Nobody. There's so many unknowns going into the season right now, not just with Nebraska, but everybody else. So who knows? Maybe Dewey knows something we don't. I don't know.